In today's video, we are going to be talking about extremes in the currency and stock market and how these extremes can potentially produce some of the best trades or high probability setups that can be great for profiting in different markets. Stay tuned, let's dive into it right now. Hello traders, investors, and entrepreneurs. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Nick, and today we're going to be talking about extremes in the market and how you can potentially trade them. Well, what do I mean by an extreme? Well, very simply put, it's when we get a massive surge to the upside or a massive surge to the downside. How can we trade these sort of situations? This topic specifically for me is absolutely fascinating. When we get markets that are absolutely driven by fear or driven by greed, this is actually where you can find some of the best setups in my opinion. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna use a stock market reference to make a little bit of a point here so that we can hopefully convert that to currencies. Stay tuned, we'll give some examples. Recently, with everything that's gone on, there have been some incredible opportunities to find overextended or stretched markets that are driven mostly by fear and greed, in my own experience and opinion. These are often some really great reversal setups, which we're gonna show how we could potentially look for those. So we're gonna use a stock market example, and let's take a look at the S&P 500, if I could type it in correctly, the S&P 500 here. We've got a very, very steep sell-off recently. Now, this is the daily chart, so take a look at with me, how far gone this market has sold off. So let's say that from the lows of 2018, you can see we actually rallied in the stock market a total of something like 46, 45%, an absolutely incredible gain on the S&P 500. Well, in just a few weeks recently, we've seen some of the craziest extremes in markets history. You can actually see from the highs down to the lows, in just like 3 or 4 weeks, we dropped 35, 36% off of the highs. That is an absolutely incredible rally to the downside. Bears basically completely took over this situation due to medical and financial crisis around the world. So with that said, where's the opportunity in all of this? Well, what you can see is that this would be considered an extreme. This sell-off is an absolute extreme, no question. Now, the thing here though is, with this, how do you know where the bottom is or the top is if the market is rising incredibly, right? Well, the short answer is we don't know. And we never really know where the top or bottom of a massive, massive movement like this really is. But there are some tools and things we can look at to potentially gauge how stretched a market really is. There are some simple oscillators and some simple technical analyst kind of tools that we can use to kind of detect how stretched a market is. Now, just because a market is really, really stretched does not necessarily mean that it is time to absolutely turn around. That's not really how markets work. Markets can trend very strongly one way or the other, even when they are going incredibly sharp directions. But it does become a higher and higher probability setup, in my opinion, and from my own testing, as markets get stretched one way from the other. So the further it gets away, the more high probability there is to actually fade or oppose the move. This is a highly contrarian topic, and some people really don't like this idea. They really don't like the idea of buying a market that is dipping like this or selling a market that is rallying so incredibly hard. So how can we as traders take advantage of these sort of situations? Well, we have to think about something for a moment. When we actually sold off here, all you could see in the news was absolute pessimism. Okay, news that was just screaming sell, sell, sell. We just had so much bearish news. And at a certain point, there gets to be so much overcrowding on the short and on the pessimistic and the negative side that there is a strong bullish rally right around the corner. If everybody is selling, guess what tends to happen in the market? Eventually, the sellers run out and we see a sharp bounce as we have seen recently on the stock market. You can actually see from the lows here to that recent jump, we had a 21% increase in the stock market in something like 4 or 5 days, right? An incredible rally on the stock market in just a matter of days. And we see this happening in the currency market as well. So we get these extremes, and they tend to happen when everybody is overcrowded on one side of a trade. Everybody was buying puts, everybody was shorting the market, everybody was selling their stocks during this time. There were so many people doing that, and there were very few people who were buying. So how would you have known that this was going to be the bottom? Again, we don't know exactly where that bottom is going to be, but as this market became more and more stretched, I actually ended up buying some stocks that I wanted to buy along the way here. Now, I was not perfect, and so this brings me to another concept that people really, really don't like to talk about, or at least it's a very unpopular topic, but it's one that I personally really like and find that it tests out pretty decently. I like the idea, if you have a decent sized account, in averaging in or averaging down or up on a trade. Now, I know that's gonna bring a lot of people to cringe and to kind of panic, but averaging in, if you do it correctly, actually is a decent strategy in my opinion. Let's say that you highlight a couple different supportive levels and you think that there's a good chance that we could rally off that level. Now, I don't, let's just say that we chose a couple different random levels, and let's say that our technical analysis said, you know, these are levels to buy based on the support. Well, if we wanted to average into the trade, let's say we don't know where the bottom is on a crazy move like this, but we decide, okay, I'm gonna buy a very small piece here, I'm gonna buy a very small piece here, and I'm a very small piece here. And then when the markets rally, we actually take profit on two of those trades, and one closes for a loss. This is the concept of averaging in this case we would be averaging down, and it is a very unpopular topic because a lot of people think it is completely stupid, but here's the thing. Anything in trading that everybody says is stupid, or kind of mantras or things like that, you know, where everybody says that's dumb, a lot of times that's not necessarily always the case. Of course, one thing that I would say is always a bad idea is using high lot sizes or using massive leverage, but there are people who would disagree with me who have made fortunes themselves doing that, and if that's for you, by all means, go for it. But my opinion is not to use massive positions. So regardless of what your opinion is, what's important as a trader is finding things that work for you, studying things that you like best, and sticking to them. So if we have a massive trend like that, that is option number one, right? We could do option number one, which is looking to average in, maybe at supportive levels, maybe at extensions, maybe at Fibonacci's, maybe at Bollinger Bands. That's one idea. Another idea is to wait for a sign of potential reversal. Now, this is never going to be a perfect thing because sometimes these are fake moves, as we've seen a lot of times here on the stock market recently. We've seen a nice rise followed by a steep sell, nice rise, steep sell, right? And now we're seeing a rise. So that's another thing, is you could wait for confirmation. It's not always a perfect indicator, and sometimes you miss the move. But if we saw something like a higher low here, right, and then the breakout, that might actually be a beautiful trade, and you're still stretched very hard from the recent highs. So when a market gets really, really stretched and we start to see signs of a potential reversal, if you're good enough and you can catch the signs of that reversal, this could be a potentially really profitable setup or strategy. And I know a lot of people who love these concepts. Another version of this concept is a trend line break strategy, right? For example, let's say that you have a trend line and you're basically watching this level. Well, if price decides to break this trend line, maybe you look to get long on a retest, right? That's another setup that you could use to trade these overextended levels. So another one that we've been seeing recently is AUD/USD. We could pull this one up and take a look at this chart. For example, we've got this strong downtrend, and we've actually seen this thing fall through the floor recently as price basically broke lower and lower and lower with everything that's going on in the news, medical and financial crisis around the world, right? Australia's gotten really hit hard, and so we've seen a lot of extremes in this market. But look at how price, as it became more and more stretched, we actually saw the snapback become more and more likely as this market fell, right? So this is not, of course, you don't know the bottom by any means when you're looking at it in the real time, but you know that as things get more and more stretched, a lot of times there's a high probability that they will snap back, and a lot of times in an aggressive way. So we can see here, right, that price basically was snapped very far. And now look at this. If we take a look at a rally off of the lows here on AUD/USD, we actually see at this point, we are still up 650 pips in just a few days. This is the daily chart. That's 8 days, 6 trading days, and we're up 660 pips in a matter of just that short time. Okay, so you get these chaotic moves to the downside, but a lot of times they are followed by sharp bounces, or if they're to the upside, sharp falls and retracements, right? So as a trader, we can trade them by looking for signs of reversal, averaging in, if you like that sort of concept, or, you know, just generally speaking, you can look for signs of reversal or breakouts, right? So here's another setup. Let's say that we're extended to the downside in this overall market you think in the long term is probably a bit too stretched. Well, if we start to see something like a rise back to this trend line here, and then we get something like the breakout here, the retest might actually present a decent trading setup that is still a rebound from this sold off market, right? A lot of times people like to trade the rebound. Again, the biggest criticism of this component is that if you wait for the rebound, a lot of times you miss a bunch of the move. Now, it doesn't matter what you do in trading. There's going to be people who oppose you and say what you're doing is dumb. You can't always just listen to what other people do because then you'll never actually take a trade yourself. You have to be able to think for yourself. You have to be able to test these things. So I encourage you, don't just copy what I'm saying in this video. Don't look for easy answers on the internet. Take what you're hearing in these videos and go test it for yourself. Go do the back testing. Pull up a chart that you like, whatever it is, AUD, USD. If you like stocks, look at stocks and go back in time and test these concepts to see how they would have done. Backtesting is a huge component of whatever you decide to do. And I think that it's very, very, very important. So go do the due diligence that it was required to become a successful trader. You've got this. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you next time.